Research shows parents are the number one reason teens choose not to drink. That means your child needs you to talk with them about alcohol. These conversations can be hard. How do you know where to start, or what to say, or what if they tell you they've already tried alcohol? Don't worry, we're here to help. Let's look at four common pitfalls many parents make when talking with their children about alcohol and how you can avoid them.
Let's take a look at the wrong way to start the conversation with your child.
You know drinking is bad, right?
Yeah.
I mean, seriously, you're not old enough. It could hurt your brain. You should never, ever get in the car with somebody who's been drinking. I mean, you could get alcohol poisoning. Well, and you should never drink and drive either.
I know.
So, getting the conversation started off right is key. To make the most of the conversation, plan out what you want to cover ahead of time. Find a good time to talk and don't try to cover everything at once. Talk with them, don't lecture them. Now let's see the right way to start the conversation.
Do we have everything we need?
Yep.
So while we have a little time, I'd like to talk to you a little bit about drinking.
Okay.
I trust you, but we need to be clear about my expectations when it comes to alcohol.
Here's another missed opportunity to talk with your teen.
Hey Mom, I'm leaving in 15 minutes to pick up Lauren.
You better not be hanging out with any kids that are doing any drinking.
No Mom, most of my friends are good kids.
What do you mean, most?
For effective communication, it is important to ask your child how they feel about alcohol and kids that drink. Listen and don't interrupt. This approach will help your child feel heard and respected, and that makes the conversation more productive.
So let's see how you would put these tips into action.
What are your thoughts about alcohol? Do you have any friends that drink?
Some kids drink at my school, but I think it's really dumb and I don't understand why they do it.
What if situations can be effective, but avoid using scare tactics as seen here.
Mom, have you seen my keys?
If I find out there's drinking at that party tonight, you are in so much trouble. You could lose your license, you can go to jail, you'll mess up your whole life. Just don't do it, okay?
Yes, but have you seen my keys?
Using what-if situations throughout the conversation will help you avoid scare tactics that are proven not to work. Guide your child to take a stand and make their own decision to say no to alcohol. The more prepared your child is, the better they will be able to handle a high-pressure situation.
Here's the right way to use what-if situations.
What would you do if you were at a friend's house and kids started drinking?
I'm not sure. I never really thought about it.
If you ever find yourself in a situation like that, kids are drinking and you feel trapped, just call me. I'll come and pick you up. You wouldn't be in trouble.
Parents don't always set clear boundaries. Here's an example.
I'm headed out. I'll see you later.
Now you're a good kid. You're not going to disappoint us.
When parents establish clear rules about drinking, their children are less likely to drink. Some examples of these rules are: do not drink until you're 21. Never ride in a car with someone who has been drinking. Stay away from parties where you know there will be drinking. Develop an agreement with you and your child regarding alcohol and don't back down. The enforcement and discipline you set up will protect your child in the long run. Let your children know exactly what you expect of them.
I want you to have fun with your friends, but your safety and future are my top priority. If you break any of these rules that we've talked about, including any drinking, there will be consequences.
I understand.
Remember, You don't have to cover all of this information at one time. You'll make a greater impact by having ongoing talks with your child. Make this the first of many conversations and let them know your expectation when it comes to alcohol use and check in with them often. For more information, visit our website, safeandsoberparents.com.